Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Avogadro's number n, the mole. Scientists come across various calculations where they have to see the number of particles, and calculating the number of atoms, which are very small in size, is not an easy job. So we use Avogadro's number. Avogadro's number is the number of particles in a mole of a substance, and it is denoted by ma, and the number of particles would be 6.02 × 10²³ particles or atoms or molecules. If we see this number, in fact this is a very huge number, which would mean 602 hexillion particles. So we write it in scientific notations. We shorten it up and write it as 6.02 × 10²³ particles of or atoms or molecules. It is similar to a dozen. A dozen is a term which means that there are 12 objects in a dozen. If we say we want a dozen oranges, that would be 12 oranges. And everybody would know by heart that it means 12 number of oranges. Similarly, Avogadro's number means 6.2 × 10²² number of particles or atoms. Let's see what a mole is. A mole is amount of substance which is contained in 6.02 × 10²³ number of particles, molecules or formula units. If we want a mole of lithium, we see what we check out the periodic table, and we see that there is this number at the bottom. This gives the atomic mass of lithium. From atomic mass, if we take it in grams, that will give you 1 mole of lithium. So this means that 6.94 taken in grams will give you 1 mole of lithium, and 1 mole of lithium, which means 6.94 grams of lithium, will contain 6.02 × 10²³ atoms of lithium. Similarly, atomic mass of carbon expressed in grams will give you 1 mole of carbon. And molecular mass of sulfuric acid in terms of grams will give you 1 mole of sulfuric acid. Now let's see the difference between molecule and gram molecule. Molecule is formed by chemical combination of atoms. This is the smallest unit of a substance, which shows the properties of the substance. So for example, H2O molecule, which contains 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom, and carbon dioxide molecule contains 1 carbon and 2 oxygen atoms combined together chemically. So this makes molecule of carbon dioxide. On the other hand, gram molecule. Now gram molecule is the molecular mass of a compound expressed in grams. So if we see in case of water, the gram molecular mass of water will be 18 grams, which will be equal to 1 mole. How we calculated that? In the periodic table, we can see that atomic mass of hydrogen atom is 1.0079. And if we take it in grams, if we take the atomic mass in grams, that will give you the gram atomic mass of hydrogen. Then we take the gram atomic mass of oxygen, which will be 16 grams. So if we see the formula, there is 2 atoms of hydrogen. Gram atomic mass of hydrogen will be 1 multiplied by 2 plus gram atomic mass of oxygen will be 16 grams. And there is only 1 atom of oxygen, so we will write it once, and this will be equal to 18 grams. This will give you gram atomic mass of water molecule. Let's see the difference between atom and gram atom. Atom is the smallest particle of an element. It is electrically neutral, means that it carries no charge on it, neither positive nor negative. It is electrically neutral. It can or cannot exist independently. Examples are potassium atom of potassium, an atom of sodium, an atom of helium, an atom of neon, etc. Let's see what periodic table. Next we have molecular mass versus the molar mass. Molecular mass is the sum of atomic masses of all elements present in a chemical, in a substance. So for example, the molecular mass of water, we can find out from the periodic table that hydrogen has atomic mass 1, and since there are two atoms of hydrogen in H2O, so we will multiply 1 with 2, plus the atomic mass of oxygen will be 16. You can find that out from your periodic table. So when you take the sum of these, 2 plus 16 will give you 18, A and U. We express molecular mass in A and U. Molecular mass of chlorine is Cl2, molecule of chlorine is Cl2. So in this case, atomic mass of chlorine is 35.5 from the periodic table, you can find it out. And you will multiply with 2 because there are 2 atoms of chlorine in the chlorine molecule. So you will get 71 A and U. This is the molecular mass of chlorine molecule. Molar mass, on the other hand, is the mass of 1 mole of a substance is called the molar mass. So molecular mass of water is 18 gram per mole. This gives you the molar mass of water. Now let's see the difference between chemical formula and gram formula mass. Chemical formula is compounds are expressed in terms of a chemical formula. This gives you the number of elements and the types of elements present in a compound. So for instance, we see benzene. Benzene is made up of 6 carbon atoms and 6 hydrogen atoms. So this C6H6 is the chemical formula of benzene. Chemical formula of table salt, sodium chloride is NaCl. This tells you that there is 1 atom of sodium and 1 atom of chlorine. This makes up the sodium. Now let's see what gram formula mass is. In case of an ionic compound, the sum of atomic masses of all the elements in an ionic compound will give you the gram formula mass of an ionic compound. Sodium chloride is an ionic compound from periodic table. You can see atomic mass of sodium is 22.99 in the periodic table, and chlorine has an atomic mass of 35.45 grams. You take the sum, since sodium chloride has 1 atom of sodium and 1 atom of chlorine, so we just take the sum of atomic masses of each. Take the sodium atomic mass of sodium plus atomic mass of